Hi, I'm Jessica Knudsen. I've been working on some junk journaling projects. Gotta put this stuff away quick. I just got a new printer. I'm starting on a new project. I kind of already fussy cut some stuff here to use. I'm planning on making a fairy journal. I figured it'd be nice. But I'm kind of doing it out of an altered book. Kind of like that. I'm not very used to talking about myself. Kind of like that there. I am making an altered journal, so it kind of might seem a little different. Or decide how I want my pockets to look before starting. Because I don't like starting things and not knowing what I'm doing halfway through it. Not sure if I'm doing this exactly straight, but at least I'm trying. And yeah, I'm only doing it two different ways. I figure this way it'll be easier when it gets down to it on where the pockets are going and where I'm having things at the very end. My daughters kind of gave me the idea of a fairy journal just because the one daughter is very into fairies right now and into magical things in general. Making sure. And this way, if I want to do the backgrounds, anything,
I can do that.
I got some of the free Calico freebies online, and I figured this way I can add them in to the books a little bit. Probably gonna need some washi tape there. I completely forgot to grab a glue stick. Sorry about that. Got a nice stack here to glue on. I'm working on multiple art alternative books lately. These are different pieces of paper that I cut up from scraps. I think I'm going to have this at the bottom, or underneath. I'm going to cut off this part. Okay. I really think these collage pages are so beautiful. I kind of have lines already to follow, so I'm going to just stick with them lines. Yeah, that's going to work perfectly. Right underneath. Out of the way here. And I'm actually going to distress around this. Thank you. I guess I probably didn't need to do the inside, but that's okay. Might as well use this little piece right away too. I know I could probably use it later, but figured it'd add a little bit more of a dimension to it. I really like that one. I wonder if there is something a little more with the red. Kind of just like it that, like that. I know it's a little plain on that side, but and like this. I think I'm just gonna do it. Some of my glues are, I guess I can just use school glue. Give me one moment, I'll be right back. I'm gonna get some school glue. People use Fab Attack or Eileen's, but sometimes that stuff is just not affordable where Elmer's glue is. And normally I add a little bit of water so it adds a little bit more like a paper mache type feeling to it. I found that it works just the same as paper mache. So why buy the expensive stuff if I can just buy it Elmer's glue? I feel like it's missing something. I got just recently stamps. I wonder if there is a pretty flowery stamp or something I can put up here. I don't really like the idea of a stamp. It's a nice idea in ways. I also made a bunch of these little label things that are different colors. I wonder if I have one that would be kind of bold. And then add a little bit of distress ink maybe to it. I think that would work. Just seeing if maybe I have something else that would look cute. stress that. Let's stress this quick. Get all that white out of it. I should really just stick it on this. Don't normally stick it on, but ooh, that's a little dark. Oh well. That happens. Not a big deal. But I've been dealing with a lot when it comes to my ex lately. Not a big deal. I don't mind being a single mom. Mind having to deal with craziness. Seems like it's been kind of calm since it's been just me and the girls. I kind of like it. Don't get me wrong, I kind of don't miss dating anyone or being with anyone. I can sit at home and do this whenever I want. I have to worry about somebody telling me, oh, you need to do this. You know. I would normally stick something in here, but on this, but I think the person who's gonna get this journal may not like that idea. Like this itty bitty flower, I think, right there. And let's hopefully stress this. There we go. I know I kind of distressed the entire thing, but that's okay. Not a big deal. I kind of meant to. It's a little too bright for me. Hopefully you can hear me. I know I'm not the loudest person in the world. I don't try to do that, but it happens. First day jitters, I think it is more like it. This is the first time I'm filming myself crafting. normally a very quiet person. I keep to myself a lot. Make sure it stays down like I want it to. And I'll probably be sticking washi tape on it. So let's see. Journaling cards. Maybe that one. Yeah, I think that one is what I want. I get all these fairies out of the summer fairy book. The fairy book was kind of slowly, well, it was kind of falling apart. So I kind of decided, let's use the pages that I could salvage and try to make it look cute for something. Sides. I'm not particular about making it perfect. I know some people are perfectionists, and it's like, why? It wrecks the art in my mind. But I like that. That looks so beautiful. So I'm just going to do this one page for today. I kind of want to put this away, and actually I just want to glue this down. Give the book time to dry and we'll be able to have time doing this some more tomorrow, because I want to show you guys some gorgeous Happy Mail, so I can use that a little bit too. Tiny pieces everywhere. Well, if you didn't see a little bit ago, I went off and bought 100 stamps from Diane. They're gorgeous stamps. Just utterly gorgeous. Different ones. A lot of these like 5-cent, 2-cent ones, but I still think they're vintage and cute, beautiful. Crusade Against Cancer. Just all sorts of different kinds. And then, sorry, can you move a little? Oh, I don't mean to keep on moving you on accident. The glue stick away and the ink quick. Close this. But I got some Happy Mail from Homespun, I want to say it's called. Homespun by Karen. And it's 10 plus pieces, $2 a piece. But I'm kind of excited about it because I don't have much. Oh, I got another stamp. Nitty bitty heart. But it looks like she took some pieces and digitals and a pretty little flower napkin and a yellow coin purse. Or coin envelope. Really cute with a little butterfly and sunflower and a cupcake and die-cutted heart out of old paper, piece of the cupcake, and some old scrapbooking paper, a looks like a tag that she decided not to use. Pictures from magazines, cutoffs of stationery, a plain white envelope, numbers, some more scrapbooking papers, oh, and another tiny envelope, and then she put this wonderful flamingo washi tape on them. This one has a lot of itty bitty hearts too.